This is the Wally Show podcast with Wally, Gavin, and me, Betty Rock. You can always find us at wayfm.com/Wally or stream us live every weekday morning through the WayFM app.
The Wally Show podcast is brought to you by Colorado Christian University Online, where Wally teaches and where you can earn a degree online just like Betty Rock. You can learn more at ccu.edu/Wally. This podcast is also brought to you by United Faith Mortgage. Let their direct lender advantage save you time and money.
Uplifting WayFM.
News can be a little heavy, so we like to do news-ish. Here's Betty.
In a recent study, 41% of Americans would admit, yeah, I'm underweight. I'm overweight.
Oh, sorry. I'm like, I wish.
Yeah, boy, what a great problem
overweight.
To have. Yeah, okay, overweight. I can see that.
And it's no wonder. I mean, when you look at the things that you have to eat to stay healthy, like kale, spinach, it's just not good. And then when you have McDonald's chicken nuggets and Oreos.
So cotton candy and all these things that are just... More fun.
It does. It just tastes a lot better. But England found out something interesting that could help those dealing with weight gain. They claimed that if food labels started adding to it the amount of exercise it would take to burn off that food item, it would make people hesitate a bit more and make better choices.
I love this idea because, like, they a few years ago, multiple years ago, they did the whole calories thing. And, like, everything has to have a calorie count, which helps you, right, Gavin? Because that's how you're doing it.
Because if I try to track all my numbers, even, like, the littlest things, I try my best to look at. And if everything's got it, then I'm able to keep track of myself better and keep myself more accountable.
So that's a great first step, calorie counting. You know, okay, great. This idea is so great because I contend that a lot of like working out and stuff like that, you're better off to manage your portion controls than you are to like go, oh, I'm going to go walking today. Walking is good for you for other reasons, mm-hmm. but for weight loss, you could walk half an hour to burn like 100 calories. So like a 100 calorie pack of something you thought was decent for you, you're going to go walk 30 minutes or an hour to get rid of.
Yeah.
So if you know that going in, when you look at that Big Mac and it says you're going to have to walk from here to New York to get rid of this thing.
Right, exactly. Well, I have a couple of examples for you. So a can of Coke, that takes...
And that's my favorite.
It's about 139 calories.
Okay.
You would have to walk for 30 minutes or run for 15.
Oof, I can't run for 15. Not straight.
No.
If you want a sleeve of Oreos, that's approximately 210 calories.
Oh,
so you're
bad.
Looking at walking for 45 minutes or running for 25.
Okay.
If you have a large pizza.
Yeah.
Or maybe a Big Mac, 500 calories. You walk for an hour and a half.
Wow.
Or run for 45 minutes.
See, this is a really good thing, I think, because you look at this and you're staring at that Big Mac going, I really want this. But if you really do the math in your head and you're like, I don't have an hour and a half to dedicate to this to get this back off of me, maybe I will pass on it. I think this is a really, really good idea. It's just a great way to real world visualize the cost of something.
Instead of having to like get out a calculator and figure out calories and all that stuff.
Because you can easily cheat your calories for that day.
That's
I'm
true.
Close and I just went 100 over. But if you're like, well, I went 800 calories over and I'm going to be walking for the next, well, hour, 3 hours, you know, it puts it into perspective.
But it was worth it.
Yeah, that's true. Some things might be. Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. It doesn't take a lot sometimes to make your day. This happened to me at Lowe's the other day. So I'm there and I met like the greatest employee at the Columbia Lowe's. He was so helpful and so kind. I'm like, man, good on you. You are crushing your job. I respect you. And it's funny because at one point in time, though, he kind of stopped me and asked me, he goes, are you famous? And sometimes people ask me things like that and they know the show and they're trying to figure out if I'm that guy from the Wally Show. You know, like, oh, do you ever do a radio show? Well, yes, I do. And so that's where I thought this was going. And I thought, yeah, well, I said, no, I'm not. I said, I do a radio show on Way FM. And he was like, oh, okay, that's cool. No. And like, so he didn't listen. So I'm like, okay, this is weird. He's like, oh, Way FM. He's like, my dad listens to that too. So maybe I've seen a video or something like that. And I said, okay, that's cool. He goes, yeah, I don't know. He's like, you just got this like hipster dad vibe. And I'm like, you know what, son? I'll take that.
Son.
He even, and this will kill Betty Rock, he even goes, I said, oh, I appreciate that. Thanks, man. I said, I'm just trying to stay young, I guess. He's like, yeah, I mean, you got the earrings going and just a cool look. I'm like, what just happened?
Yeah. This kid needs help.
Yeah, this kid found a mentor.
Was he trying to upsell you something? Like, well, trying to charm you so that you'll buy something else?
I did buy a brand new kitchen that I didn't need.
Oh, there you go.
So, he did a
great job.
Yeah, no, he had no vested interest in this whatsoever.
He just thought you looked cool.
Yeah, and I'm like, well, daggum, like, that's all right. And I look at my wife, I'm like, you're lucky to be with this guy.
You married up.
That's right, you did. So I am curious, though, okay? Have you ever gotten that comment that just made you feel cool? Maybe it's from a stranger at Lowe's. Like, this kid's going places. I hope he does really well.
And I think with people your age,
yes,
you know, around your age, you need those comments from the younger generation to make you feel like, yeah,
absolutely.
I'm still hip.
Yeah.
I'm still with it.
Yeah. And sometimes it comes from your kids. Like, your kids surprise you and you think that they think you're the lamest ever. And then they say something like, oh, all right, way to go. Or random strangers. I don't know. I'm just curious if you've ever been in that situation where you're like, oh my goodness, this person just made me, even though I'm of extended years, made me feel cool. 855-33-WAY-FM. And if you haven't, I can send you directions to this Lowe's and maybe this kid will make you feel better. 855-33, but you're going to have to work hard at it because I've raised the bar for coolness in the Lowe's, apparently.
I don't know. He must not get out much.
855-33-WAY-FM is the number. We'll take yours now. Lisa, how old are you and what was the time that someone made you feel cool?
I'm 56. I work for a national pizza delivery company. I won't say which one. And I realized that I didn't understand how our drivers felt when they delivered, so I started delivering pizzas. And when I told one of them that, they said, oh, cool. You are a cool woman. I'm thinking, well, thank you, because, you know, you're 29 and you think that I actually am not a grumpy old woman.
Nice.
And they said, well, you do really get it. And I said, yep, I do. I'm HR. I don't even work in the stores. I do payroll. I do all that. So that is really out of my wheelhouse. So
yeah, see, what makes you cool, though, is that you care about these people enough, even though, you know, it's not technically your job, but you want to understand them better so that you can better serve them. And I think that's super cool.
Well, thank you, Wally.
And that's coming from a guy that was told by a dude at Lowe's that he's a hipster cool dad. So have you ever had someone make you feel a little cooler there, Tano?
Absolutely. It's never my kids.
Yeah, your kids don't get you.
No, but my kids' friends are like, your mom's hilarious. I take that, and they're like, that's because she's not your mom.
Yeah.
You know, I enjoy when they think I'm fun, and my kids are just rolling their eyes.
It's so funny how, yeah, your kids don't find you funny, you know, or whatever, or you're an embarrassment to them, but their friends are like, man, your mom's awesome. You know, I wish my mom was like your mom. That always feels good.
It's nice. I used to teach sixth grade, and the sixth graders would tell my kids that I was funny, or they'd be like, I want to be in her class because she's so funny. And I'm like, yeah, I am.
I feel like this is something Wally tried to do with his own daughter when she had friends over, except nobody laughed. But yeah. He was like, I'm still funny. I'm still relevant.
This is a great example of how your kids don't fully understand or appreciate you. So there's this other competitive Christian radio station called The Fish, and they have a morning show with this dude, Kevin and Taylor, okay? And so we were at an event one time, and they happened to be at the same event. And my daughter was like 9 or whatever, and she looks at me. She goes, Dad, there's Kevin from The Fish. Do you think you can introduce me? And I'm like, are you kidding me? Like, I am 10 billion times cooler than that guy. And I'm like, come on, let's go. You know? And so she just didn't get it. She didn't see it.
Yes, absolutely. They never see it. There's a little saying that say weird moms build character. And that's what I'm trying to do.
There you go. I love it, Tennille. You're the best, girl. Thank you.
Have a good day.
And now for some good news.
Uplifting Way FM. This year's the Wally Show. A little good news giddy up, a roundup of some good news stories designed to make you feel a little bit better because the regular news is a bit of a bummer. We're going to start with you, Betty Rock. Good news giddy up. Go.
So there was a mom in Fort Myers, Florida. She was trying to buy a birthday cake for her 3-year-old daughter, but, you know, Hurricane Ian came through and the grocery stores just didn't have any birthday cakes. But a woman at the bakery did track her down in the store a few minutes later. She said, hey, I found a birthday cake in the back of the freezer. I can put a tiara on it and I can write happy birthday, Anna.
Nice.
And so that's exactly what she did. This three-year-old got her birthday cake and it's just precious.
Well, I love that too because it's easy to just go, oh yeah, we don't have it, especially with everything that's gone on in Fort Myers with Hurricane Ian. And so the fact that this person found it, tracked her down, and,
yes,
and went above and beyond for this little girl who, you know, who knows what their situation is. And I just think that's is super cool. There was a mom that posted a video of her newborn on TikTok. And, you know, people are always commenting on things. You're like, oh, no. You're almost nervous to put out stuff sometimes because you got the trolls. Well, a stranger messaged her. And this time said something about her child's eye, but not in a bad way. She was like, something doesn't look right in your child's eye. And it turns out the mom had been turned away by her normal doctor before, but went to a specialist based on this information from a complete stranger on TikTok. Found out the child had a condition that would have caused him to lose sight in his eye if left untreated. They did the procedure and saved his vision.
Oh, my goodness.
Like, how crazy is that? And not like he was going to lose his vision 5 years from now. Like, they were talking months from now.
Wow.
Yeah, and so the mom said, I'm so grateful for her reaching out. It's something that I will never forget. It would be lovely. It would be lovely to have an impact on someone else's life like that.
That's awesome. Yeah, that's when the internet actually works for good.
Yeah, you love it when it gets it right, and that's why we like to highlight those moments here on Good News Giddy Up.
Coffee shops, poolside, back porch, picnic table at the park, at your kid's soccer practice. Just about anywhere can be your classroom when you decide to go back to school online at Colorado Christian University.
I know I got my degree online and I actually did a homework at a campsite. I was sitting around a campfire writing a paper. That is where I did some of my work that weekend. So life doesn't have to stop just because you go back to school to better yourself. You can work towards this future and this goal that you want to accomplish, and it doesn't have to totally consume you or derail your normal life with friends, your family, or what have you.
And you can earn accredited degrees from Colorado Christian without ever setting foot on campus.
So there really shouldn't be an excuse to not going back to school. If it's something you really want to do, you can do it. And all you have to do is go to ccu.edu/Wally to learn more. And the other really important thing is that Colorado Christian is committed to cultivating the mind without compromising the heart. So check it out, ccu.edu/Wally.
Uplifting Way FM.
Here's what's going on today.
So if you don't live in Florida, you're probably like, okay, I saw the stories about Hurricane Ian, and it's not in the news much anymore, so everything should be good, right? That is so not the case. When these storms come through and they just decimate an area, the cleanup and getting back to normal is something that takes years to accomplish. I mean, because you look at this, when you see the pictures, there were entire neighborhoods that were just gone, you know, and so that doesn't get rebuilt overnight. There's still people without power, and it's going to be a long time in the making for them to recover from this. And here's something, though, I didn't think of, is that the devastation from Hurricane Ian left schools shuttered. I didn't even think about that. I was just thinking about people's personal lives and stuff like that. Some of the schools have been shut down because of it.
So that means the kids can't go to school.
Exactly. Mm. And so they were damaged, or there are some schools that still don't have power, and they're trying to figure out how they move forward. And then there are teachers and administrators that lost their homes, and so they can't come back to work right away.
Right.
They're dealing with that. And so it's a bad situation. I guess one of the good things to come out of COVID, though, was that it forced schools around the country to learn how to go online and do school that way. And so I guess if there's any good to come from that, it's at least that kids can shift more readily when things like this happen to an online learning environment to keep them from falling too far behind and not have to wipe out a whole school year or something and repeat stuff.
Right, but that's only if they can find a place where they can get internet.
Where they can, yeah.
Yeah.
That's true, yeah.
What a mess.
It's difficult to get internet and phone calls and things like that, texts and areas like that. It's still kind of messy. So you know what, if you want to help out, like if you're like, oh yeah, it is, I guess it is still an issue, I didn't realize that, one of the things you can do is provide help through ministries that are working in areas like this and in Fort Myers and helping people. And Convoy of Hope is somebody we partner with, and they're amazing. And it's real simple. You can just text the word convoy to 91979 and we'll send you a link. Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. And Betty Rock started a new book the other day by Lisa Turkhurst. And we've had her on the show before. She's a great author. My wife is a big fan of hers. And she was pouring through, Betty was pouring through something in the book. I'm like, oh, I really like that concept.
Yeah, so the book is called Good Boundaries and Goodbyes. And I would highly recommend it. As you can see, I've got a lot of tabs on mine. These are all things that I highlighted that I thought were really good.
Who needs that much help in their life?
You could really benefit from this book. Anyways, one of the things that I took away from it, it's on page 113, and she said, picture yourself as a tiny baby fresh from God's hands, innocent, blissfully unaware of tragedy and trauma. Now imagine yourself looking at that child, and what would you say to her? What do you want to tell her she is before life gets written on her?
And I like that concept.
What she's trying to say is, because this has to do with boundaries and our identity, because it's hard to create boundaries when we see our identity in someone else, and maybe that relationship is not healthy. And so if our identity is in someone that's not treating us well, we can't create those boundaries.
And this is probably stemming from her from a really personal thing. She was married, her husband cheated on her. So that was part of one of the books of her trying to restore her marriage. And then it did not end up being restored regardless of the work that she did.
Yeah.
And so maybe that is coloring some of this as well.
But her point was, if you think about that picture of yourself as a child before life took its toll on you.
Yeah.
Whatever you would say to that child is probably the same thing you need to hear at your age, no matter the age that you are. But that what you need to tell that child is still healing for you at your age, whether you're in your 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, whatever.
Well, with all the tabs you have in that book, I'm excited to hear what yours would be. So five words, though. Condense it down. This is what we'll do. We'll do five words that you would say to that child that maybe you still need to hear today. Go, Rock. I want to hear
mine. Would be, you are already good enough.
Whoa. There's a lot in that.
I think a lot of women battle with not feeling like they're good enough, that they need to keep raising the bar. They need to be better.
Right.
And if I could tell my younger self, hey, you're already good enough, that would take away so much weight that I myself put on my own shoulders, because I think, well, I want these people to like me or accept me, so I need to be funnier, or I need to be more likable, or like, I'm not good enough as I am. I need to constantly be making myself better.
I love it. That's like super deep. Good job. Okay, so 855.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I get a gold star.
Yeah, well, see, you won my approval. You are good enough.
Oh, jeez. You need to read the book.
855-33-WAY-FM is the number. We love having you on, and I like when we get into like some serious stuff too. So what is that five-word sentence you would say to that younger baby, you know, that maybe, you know, you still need to hear today? And kind of getting it out and putting it into words like this helps you flesh it out for you personally, too. And you go, man, this is kind of revolutionary in my life. I need to be reminded of this every day. So what is your five-word sentence now? 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM.
So for you, Fonja, what are those five words that you would say to your younger self?
I would say that you are loved beyond measure. I think that sometimes we just feel we're not loved, and we are truly loved by our Heavenly Father.
And when we don't feel loved, that leads us into very unhealthy relationships, because we're looking for that love from another human being, which they're sinful just like we are. So it's just going to lead to more of a mess. But you're right. So that when we find the love that we need through Christ, we're already full in our own capacity, and we're not looking for it in someone else.
Yeah, it's kind of like when you're in a relationship, that should add to the love that you had. It shouldn't be the thing that creates it.
Exactly.
Right.
That's a great one, Fonja. I really like it. And I think it's something a lot of us need to hear and be reminded of daily. What five words would you say to yourself? Because there is a good chance that what you're telling that child, your younger you, is what older you needs to hear. So, Mike, what are those five words you would say?
Your parents sin, stop here.
Okay, explain that to me a little bit. I'm fascinated by that.
I'm trying to overcome the sins that my parents have laid on me. Like, I come from an alcoholic family.
Yeah.
And I'm take every day step by step to try not to repeat mistakes that they made.
So now, are you currently in recovery, or you have just always avoided it, or what?
I have always avoided it, knowing the blood that I come from.
That's smart.
I've just done everything I can to keep a hold on it.
Well, good for you, man, because that stuff, you give it an inch, it can take a mile. And so that's a great five-word sentence. And I think maybe inspirational to somebody else that, you know, looks at life and goes, well, it's my heredity. I can't do anything to change it. And you're living proof that you can, but you have to be intentional. So, man, that's awesome, Mike. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Linda, what would your five-word sentence to younger you/older you be?
You were made for this.
Okay, so what is the this that you're made for?
So I lead an organization, and going through the pandemic and going through other trials that organizations go through, and then I'm in Florida and, you know, hit straight on with the hurricane, and you have to listen to God and hear him say, you were made for this.
So in a way, it's comforting because you know that whatever is coming your way, whatever's in the future, there's no need to have anxiety over it because you know that God is going to carry you through it and also prepare you for what's ahead.
That's exactly it. You think of the fathers of faith and the mothers of faith in the Bible, and you look and they're like, okay, they faced a lot. I can do this too.
It's like that Matthew West song.
Right.
Which one?
Any of them. No, I'm drawing a blank on it. Strong enough. It's like that Matthew West song, Strong Enough. And I think she's describing that where God must think we're strong enough if he's going to give us certain things. He's equipped us to go through them.
I know I'm not strong enough to be everything that I'm supposed to be. I give up. I'm not strong enough.
I saw that going differently in my mind.
Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. How would you like to be the most interesting person in every room you walk into? Well, you can now with a little thing we like to call Mind Blown!
Mind Blown.
Nice.
Mind Blown.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, you're not going to be able to follow that
no,
up, Gavin.
No, she's changing it up these days.
I get it.
It's hard to track.
I get it. Yeah, you're in a tough spot there. So here we go. The way it works is we'll have a scenario here of us just kind of talking at a gathering, and I will show you how this works and how you can work in these nuggets, these factoids, to make you more interesting than anyone else in the room that you're with. So let's start with you, Betty Rock.
Well, I know you're not a sporty person.
Oh, no.
But I want to mess you up. I'm going to even take it one step further. I want you to tell me something about women's sports.
Okay. That is a hard one for me.
Mm-hmm.
I think I can blend two worlds here though with a mind-blowing fact, okay?
Okay.
Did you know, and I love that you are all about women empowerment, Betty Rock, cuz I am mm-hmm. too. That's something near and dear to my heart. See, this is what you do. You ingratiate yourself
yep.
with them,
yep.
find some common ground. You know, us girls got to stick together, Rock.
my goodness.
Wait, what?
I'm trying to find that common ground. Did you know that there has only ever been one woman picked in the NBA draft? Did you even know
what?
That? Yeah, even
really?
Gavin. Look, even
that
Gavin looks stunned.
Is fascinating.
Gavin is. See, I,
oh.
Gavin was walking by.
Uh-huh.
He was headed to the restroom and he stopped. He's
wait.
Like, wait, what?
Do you think it's fascinating because there's only one? Like, you think?
Yeah.
Well, yes, because
there should be more.
No,
or there should
no,
not be
no.
Any?
There shouldn't be more because there is literally a WNBA and
right.
an NBA. There is. The Women's National Basketball no. Association.
Oh, but to
so
choose
why?
A woman for the NBA
yes.
is kind of odd. I see.
Yeah. I don't think she ever played.
Yeah, look at the conversation that's happening right now. We're all in. Everybody's in going, where is this going? Her name is Louisa Harris, and she was drafted by the New Orleans Jazz. They took her in the 7th round. All the way back in 1977. Okay, so it's
okay.
been a while since this has,
yeah.
and it hasn't happened again since then.
Yeah. Okay.
But it turns out she was pregnant and she never played in a game.
But like, they did pick her?
Yeah.
Did they?
Wait, really?
Why yeah. would they pick someone who was pregnant?
I don't think they knew, maybe, you know?
Oh,
so
geez.
Anyway, so there you go. That's a fascinating fact. Gavin is still Googling.
This
Gavin,
is, oh.
if we were at a gathering, Gavin would be on his phone trying to add to the conversation. We've pulled him in. Gavin, let me get your face out of Google for
okay.
a minute here. And like now,
coming out.
Give me something else. I'm on a roll here.
Okay, let's go from like sports to... I've been feeling very patriotic
okay.
lately. How about American history?
America. Oh, okay. I got you. I got you on this one. Okay, so you know, you guys know, right? Again, ask questions is good. One of the criteria for being the president of the United States is you have to be an American citizen.
Yes.
You know that, right?
Yes.
Okay, that's why, like, Arnold Schwarzenegger could never be president because mm-hmm. he wasn't born mm-hmm. in the United States. Mm-hmm. But did you know that there were 7 presidents that were not born American citizens? Do you know
7?
We've had 7 presidents that were not born American citizens. How could that be possible if they, that's the rule?
But if they ascertained they were not born American citizens, but they...
Maybe they were born in an area, like it was early in the 1700s before it was considered a part of America.
Betty Rock!
That's a great point.
Betty Rock for the win!
I was right?
You got it right. These were presidents that they were born before America became America, and then they became our presidents after the Revolution.
Fascinating.
Thank you.
Look at that.
And thank you.
That is amazing. I think now my mind is blown. I didn't think anyone would get that, least of all Betty. Nicely done. Oh, sorry, that sounded bad. No, I didn't mean that, but no. I just didn't think anyone would get
just
that.
Move on.
Nicely done.
I'm walking away.
TMI. TMI, my friends.
Also known as Today's Music Insider with Gavin.
If you don't know country music star Walker Hayes by name, you might recognize the song of his that blew up on TikTok a couple years ago called Fancy Like.
Yeah, we fancy like Applebee's on a date night.
I do love this song, man. It's stuck in my head all the time. And I've watched so many videos with this on TikTok. It's awesome.
Yeah, it hasn't died. The popularity, I think, died down. But every time I hear it, it brings me back to that moment. And it's actually really cool because he... For a long time, you know, he wasn't a Christian, and he's recently become a Christian.
Yeah.
And he actually wrote this song called Craig, and it's kind of based on the guy who really kind of lived Jesus out to him and showed him what being a Christian looked like.
Yeah, I know. It sounds cool, right? Not your typical kid from Sunday school, right? I still ain't figured out church yet. But Craig, I get it.
Yeah, see, that's what's so cool, man. Like, he wasn't a believer when he wrote this song and sent it to his friend. And come full circle, he found faith, and he's, like, really on fire for God. It's a really interesting dynamic. We actually hung out with him the other day, and we'll bring you some of that in the future here. But really fascinating story of kind of a full circle finding God story is great.
Absolutely. And another thing he let us in on was that he was doing a song with none other than one of our favorite kind of country Christian stars, Zach Williams.
Yeah.
And the song is called Jesus Fault.
Oh, sorry about that. I got all excited. I'm like, yeah,
well,
come on. No. What's the song called?
It's called Jesus Fault.
I guess that's what happens when it chases you down.
That's a great line.
Yeah.
That's a great line. If you miss the old me, it's Jesus' fault. That's cool.
And I think that we all probably have, like, a story of, you know, like, the us before Jesus.
Sure.
And I think that, you know, Zach Williams and Walker Hayes have had stories about kind of where they came from. And we, you know, we talked to Walker Hayes about that, about, like, the way that he came from a life where he had, like, addictions and all this, and then found Jesus.
It's fascinating, too, because, like, he started writing with other Christian artists. Like, he's friends with Bart from Mercy Me, and we started comparing, like, people that we knew. And it was weird, he's like, because there's one line in this song. Let me play this for you real quick.
That Bible by the bed ain't a coaster no more. It's still got some rings from the bottles before.
And he was talking about this song, you know, still rings from the bottles before. Like, so you're battling alcoholism and it's still on the Bible. Like, there's still some faith there, but you're struggling through it. And when he was writing this, he talked to some other people in the Christian genre, and they're like, oh, yeah, I don't know if you can really say that. And he's like, what? I don't understand why. Like, he didn't understand that, like, people don't view things in this world the same. And I'm like, I'm so glad Zach Williams didn't take that out and left it in there, because it's real. Like, it's honest. It's not just all vertical praise songs. There's got to be more to this stuff, and it's got to be honest and real. And that's what he brought to this. And I love that fact.
Yeah, I think we as people, our tendency is to not forget, you know, the rings before. But what Jesus does is that he does actually, like, forget those things, and he does leave those behind because you've met him.
Yeah, I thought that was just really an interesting thing from him saying, you know, like, why can't you just talk about real life? And it's like, yeah, you know, you're right. And maybe we need more of that outside stuff coming into the culture to help make us more real and more relatable to people as well. So we'll have more with Walker Hayes probably next week and some of our conversation with him and his story, because I think you'll find his faith story fascinating. And we'll do that. But right now, thank you, Gavin. That's your TMI for today.
Jeffrey Bezos.
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. And we all know Jeffrey Bezos, the guy that started Amazon and made it so that we could get things delivered to our house in just days, and just about anything delivered to our house in just about days. And he has benefited greatly from this. He has yachts and spaceships, no exaggeration.
He literally has a yacht that can't get under a bridge, so it's stuck where it's at. But the bridge is like historical. They don't want to tear it apart just to get his billion-dollar yacht through.
Yeah, and they were originally going to.
But to have that problem is crazy.
So we thought we'd do something here called What Could Bezos Buy? Okay, based on your last purchase on Amazon, all you have to do simply is tell us, okay, I bought this, and the weirder the better, on Amazon. I'd love that. And how much it costs. We'll add it together for the people that call, and we'll find out what Jeffrey Bezos could buy with the money that we just gave him.
Yeah, because, okay? I mean, helping a billionaire is really what we're aiming for.
Absolutely. They need more things in their lives, you know. I don't want them to be sad. You know, so 855-33-WAY-FM is the number. It's very simple. What could Jeffrey Bezos buy? Just tell us that last thing. 855-33-WAY-FM.
Jeffrey Bezos.
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show with you, Kayla. Welcome to What Could Jeffrey Bezos Buy? He's the guy that started Amazon, and he's a multi-billionaire, but he still needs us to fund his lifestyle. So we are going to see what the last thing is you purchased, add it with a couple other people's purchases, and find out what Jeffrey Bezos could buy. So what did you buy last?
I bought a Velcro Target, like a Velcro ball Target for my son's birthday.
Okay.
And it was $15.89.
Okay, $15.89. Now, when you've got a billion-dollar yacht, that's not going to buy a whole lot for that. But maybe if we add a couple more people
to
this.
That's right. We just need more Kaylas.
All right, Ashley, you're up. What was the last thing you bought on Amazon, and how much was it?
Doggy diaper suspenders, and they were
$25. Oh, my gosh.
What do you need doggy diaper suspenders for?
We have a elderly dog, and she has a little incontinence, so she has diapers, but she pulls them off. So she needs suspenders to keep them on.
Who knew that even existed?
I had no idea.
Jeffrey Bezos did, and he knew you'd need it. This is why we're funding his lifestyle. All right, well, we got you down. That's a great one. Thank you.
Thanks.
All right, Christy, you're up. What is the last thing you bought from Amazon, and how much was it?
Hey, good morning. I bought my mama's denture adhesive.
Nice. You sure it was for your mama?
I'm positive.
Okay, how much did that set you back?
It set her back $6.99.
So let me do some math. 6.99 plus 25 from before plus 1589 equals $47.88 that Jeffrey Bezos can spend however he wants to now.
Almost $50.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, pretty crazy. So yeah. What is something Betty Rock that a millionaire you think would probably own?
Well, I was thinking a Rolex watch. I mean, most millionaires, billionaires have a Rolex watch. Now, the problem is that the cheapest one I could find costs $6,500. Okay. And when you put $50 that we can contribute, it doesn't really make a dent.
Yeah. Here's the thing about this. I looked up the smallest piece of a Rolex watch that maybe we could buy. Mm-hmm. It's the winding stem.
Oh.
Yeah, you'd think. That alone is $160.
Oh, so we can't even do that.
We cannot even buy him the winding stem unless we get a knockoff one that's not a Rolex from eBay, and we can cover that with the $47.
Yes!
So Jeffrey Bezos is still winning today.
So what is TikTok, and how do you use it?
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show, and apparently TikTok is a great place to put things out and have debates about them and kind of odd things. And Betty Rock, you came across something the other day.
Yeah, so the big question on TikTok that we're debating now is, how do you put your socks and shoes on? So I think a lot of people don't realize we have different methods to the madness.
Yeah.
So a couple of those options are, do you do sock, sock, shoe, shoe?
Absolutely.
That's and then
the
tie
only,
both?
It's the only way to do it. Sock, some... sock, shoe, shoe. If you don't, you're a serial killer. It's that easy in my world.
Some people are saying, no, I do sock, shoe, sock, no. shoe, Whoa. Then tie, tie. And some do sock, sock, shoe, tie, shoe, tie.
No, 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 no. It's just logic. Okay, every morning I sit down on the side of my tub. I leave my shoes there. And I put my sock on my right foot. It's always the same order. Sock on the right foot, sock on the left foot. That way, both feet on the cold tile are now warm. They're insulated. Then you go right shoe, left shoe, tie, tie. Oh, no, no, I do right shoe tie, left shoe tie. Yeah, that makes more sense. The other way would be anarchy.
You know, it's weird because I knew that we were going to be talking about this, so I really paid attention when I put on my shoes this morning. And it's almost like, you know, when you don't, like when you're being filmed for a video and then you can't remember what to do with your hands. Right. It was kind of like that. I was like,
you came in with your shoes on your hands this morning. That explains it.
It explains a whole lot. Yeah. I still need to get the socks off my hands. But either way, it doesn't matter. It made me think, what do I actually do?
What do you do?
I ended up doing sock, shoe, tie.
No.
Sock, shoe, tie.
Why would you do that? What is wrong with you?
You do Gavin, feel off today.
I have socks on my hands, guys. There's a lot wrong.
I do the absolute normal thing. Sock, sock, shoe, shoe, tie, tie. Like, it's all right foot first, then left foot.
Okay, now, you and I are the same except for the order of the tying.
You tie your left shoe first?
Well, no, I tie it at
you
the same
crazy,
time.
Ridiculous.
No.
Wonder.
Look, you just stay out of this right
guy?
Now because you've already proven you don't deserve to have this conversation.
Psychopath.
Yeah, weird. No, so, like, when you have your, when you've slid your shoe on, that's when you tie it. You don't.
Oh.
Yeah, because it's right there. Otherwise, you got to put your foot down. It's not efficient.
Oh, and I do it the slightly inefficient way, though.
Right, exactly. I'm just trying to help you get here.
Don't let him berate you,
I'm
Gavin.
I'm not going to change.
You do you.
I'm just trying to help Gavin get here in a timely manner because it's early. We get in early. And so I've perfected the art of getting out of the house and being able to sleep as long as possible. So I don't know. Maybe we're crazy. Maybe you have another thought on this. Did you post on this as well, Rock?
I did. I posted it on our Instagram stories, and you can see it if you follow Wally Show. But I put the options there, and the one that's winning out are sock, sock,
yep.
shoe, tie,
yes,
shoe, tie.
That's what I said, because it's normal. Anybody else that does it any other way than that is insane.
Wow, you are really bold on this.
This is what's so great about our lives. If you look at our lives in America, this is the big debate we're having. You know?
Hey, I'm here for it.
Be thankful.
Yes, exactly.
Like today, just take a minute and go, Lord, thank you. Thank you so much. This is the biggest thing on our plate today.
Exactly.
Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. And prayer is a big part of our lives as believers. And that's why we have this thing called the prayer wall at wayfm.com.
Yeah, when you go to wayfm.com, that's where you can see it. Pastor Chad has a video there explaining everything. But pretty much what it is people are there to post the prayer requests that they have. Maybe it's things that are pretty serious. Maybe it's just the mundanes of life. But it's a place where they can go and they can be anonymous if they like. But you can go to it. Also post your prayer requests as well. And pray for someone. So let's say you saw a request on there that was talking about a divorce. Well, you could read that. Then you could say, I'm going to pray for this. You click that little box. And when you do, it sends a message to their email or to their phone to that person saying, hey, somebody prayed for you. And there's no telling the effects that that can have on someone.
And there's a lot of heavy stuff on there, too. Like Diane said, hey, we need somewhere to live. And my husband needs prayers. He's angry at God. He needs healing. He hasn't taken any pills since last June.
Oof.
So it makes you think, okay, he's got like some chemical issues going on and like depression or, you know, whatever, and he needs to be balanced, but he's not doing it. And so if you're off your meds, that makes everything around you more difficult. And she says he doesn't want to live anymore. And so when you are in a place like that with somebody, you want to help him. You just want him to be okay. But you're powerless sometimes to change them. You can't do it for them. And sometimes all you can do is pray that God's going to intervene and make a difference. And that's why she's turning to the prayer wall to get help. She even says in advance, thank you for your prayers.
Yes. So if this is something that you would like to check out, if you text the word pray to 91979, we'll send you a link and that'll take you straight to the prayer wall. That's pray to 91979.
Being the parent of like a little kid, I think has gotten a lot harder than when I was raising my daughter. She's 23 now, and man, I got to tell you, the decisions you have to make and the things you have to monitor and protect your children from today has gotten a lot harder. What do you give them that's still entertaining, but also aligns with your values? You know, we've talked about Way FM being a product that you don't have to filter, but like if you got Netflix in your house, you got to have the filter on.
And even Disney Plus, you have the same problem.
Oh, well, I'll tell you, Disney Plus has been disappointing to me as a parent. And some of the things they've chose to put on there. And like, you got to watch it, you know? And that's why it's so nice to have something. If I was raising little kids, I would do PureFlix subscription, man, because you've got content on there that you're not having to filter out. And as a parent, I mean, I know we want to be involved in our kids' lives, but sometimes you need to park them in front of the TV and take 10 minutes to yourself. That's why PureFlix is a great option for families. You got family stuff, obviously. They're even dabbling in some drama. Yes, and PureFlix originals. Like, I saw the movie on their Strong Fathers, Strong Daughters, and I have to tell you,
you cried.
I did. There was three times. Not once, three times.
I did.
I wept, and I was moved, and it was a great movie. And I think if I was raising my child now, I think PureFlix would be definitely a part of my family's entertainment plan.
So if you'd like to try PureFlix, text PURE, that's P-U-R-E, to 91979 to get your 1 week free trial. Faith and Family Entertainment with no ads on your favorite devices.
Attention, please.
Uplifting Way FM. Celebrities are just like you and me. Except, of course, for the mansions, tigers, and sequins. It's The Rock Report with Betty Rock.
When NFL legend Tom Brady finally announced his retirement from football, many sports fans around the country understood but still mourned the loss of the, at the time, 44-year-old. But not long after the announcement, 40 days actually, to be exact, Brady recanted his statement with another claiming he actually realized he just needed a break, but he was ready to be back on the field.
I just needed 40 days to think it over, you know, by the same time that Noah was in the ark, and then I'm good. You know?
Yeah, he just needed a snack and a nap. He shouldn't have made a decision, you know, on
so
an empty stomach.
So he went back to football.
So he went back. And while he was met with a lot of excitement from fans, the same may have not been going on in his personal life with his wife. So sources say that he and his wife, model Gisele Bündchen?
Like that. It's hard for me to say, too.
They had both decided together that it was best he retire from the game to spend more time with his family and also just to keep his health in a good place.
And you're so far ahead. I mean, you're set for life financially. Right. You could do and not do whatever you don't want to do. And so, like, the drive for him to go back to sports when you could retire and just be with your family, not risk getting hurt, you know, and having a problem. Like, the drive for him to go back to sports, for that to fulfill him somehow, has to be huge.
Right. It could be that his identity is definitely tied into it.
I get that.
But when Brady announced that he was coming back soon after, sources say he made that decision on his own. So that him and his wife had made the decision together to retire, he had made on his own to unretire.
I'm going to say his wife made the decision for him to retire the first time, and he reluctantly probably was doing it if he went back.
I don't know. But so now the sources are claiming that Gisele, his wife, is hiring a divorce lawyer.
No.
It's gotten that serious. And most are saying it's due to her feelings like Brady is putting the game first instead of his family.
I'm curious if she's sending a message like, okay, this is it. It's me or nothing kind of thing. And if you don't, then I'm going to get divorced. Or is she hit her window and like, okay, I hit her limit. Like, I'm done. We're not going to do this.
Yeah. And then you have to think too, what's going through Tom Brady's mind, because is the game worth it for losing your family?
Yeah. It's interesting because you got kids involved and stuff like that. And so it is interesting to see if he will go, all right, I need to step away from the game to work on my family, whatever that takes, because that should be, he has the advantage too, where he can step away and not have to work to really focus on his family. How many people don't have that option?
Right.
How many people are like, I still have to do my job, but I still have to fix my family, you know? So it'd be interesting to see what he ends up choosing, or if he's like, well, now if I'm getting divorced, I better keep this job because I'm going to lose half of everything.
Oh.
Why are we wasting our time with these old people anyway?
Did you just call me old?
Uplifting Way FM. You have a chance to win a prize here with famous ages, but you're going to have to pay attention, okay? We're going to try to stump each other with the ages of celebrities and well-known personalities. And when their real age is revealed, write it down. And if you listen long enough and you get everybody together and get their actual ages added together, you can win a prize. Do you guys mind if I go first?
Please.
Today? Okay. I'm going to start off with an actor of some note. Emilio Estevez. Emilio Estevez. He is the brother of Charlie Sheen. Everybody knows Charlie Sheen, but he is the brother of Charlie Sheen.
Yeah, but has he done anything?
Yes, he was super famous. Like he not as much as Charlie Sheen, but he
was
famous.
Doing what?
Acting.
In what?
Movies.
Like, can you name one?
I can, but I don't want to, because if I do, it'll give it away.
And Charlie Sheen's not young.
Are you saying he's his younger brother? Did you say that?
I did not say that. I said he's related to.
But you said brother.
Yeah, they are brothers. It's also Charlie Sheen. What's the dad?
Martin Sheen.
Martin Sheen
is
also his dad. Emilio Estevez. Yeah.
Oh boy.
All right. So get your guesses.
Yep.
I'm gonna start with Gavin.
I think that he's gonna end up being the older brother.
Yeah.
At 62.
Okay.
I feel like I'm off.
Well, Lady Rock, what did you say?
I'm going with being the younger brother.
Oh boy.
36.
All right.
Goodness.
Wow. Well, Betty Rock, that one just hurt you.
Dang it.
He is close to Charlie Sheen. Emilio Estevez is 60.
Oh, good.
Okay. Emilio shouldn't even count.
Yeah.
Because he's not a celebrity.
He is. Do you remember the movie Breakfast Club?
Yes.
He's the star of Breakfast Club.
Oh.
So, yeah, so he is an actor.
Duh, Betty.
He did a movie with Charlie Sheen, too. So, yeah, okay. So that
you should have said that.
No, because that's the point. You would have gotten
you're
it.
You're so rude.
Okay, so let's go with yours next, now that you're taking yourself out of this statistically.
I'm going with American iconic comedian Carol Burnett.
Oh, I love Carol Burnett. The Carol Burnett Show is one of the greatest comedic shows.
Too much.
I won't, but I'm just saying it was great. It had Harvey Korman, Tim Conway on it. I would watch it. My mom loved it. My dad loved it. I would watch that all the time. I love me some Carol Burnett.
So how old is she?
Okay. I have my guess. Gavin?
Yeah, I've got mine too. I don't know who this is.
Okay, go ahead.
I think she's going to end up being a little older, and I'm going to go with 58.
Oh.
Am I taking myself out?
This hurts Gavin. I went 91, but
no,
I first wrote 89.
No.
But I'm going to stick with 91.
Mm. Well, she's 89.
Oh,
you could have been right on the money.
I had it on the money. Oh, nuts.
You
okay.
put 91.
You put 91.
I did. I did say 91.
She's 89.
Okay, so I would have had a perfect score so far going the last round. I never win this game, so I would have been so happy. But okay, so mark those two down, and then we'll do Gavin's. If you can add those all together here in 10 minutes, you can win a prize. So, Gavin.
And I'm thinking that the person that I chose is going to be too easy to even let Betty... like close to this one, but the age surprised me, and it was Pierce Brosnan.
Oh, okay. I mean, this is one that you could be off by 10 years easily, but like in a tight game, that would be a big deal. But for me, here, I should be able to run away with this bad boy. So, Pierce Brosnan, he was a Bond, and he was in Mamma Mia.
Yep.
So, I've got my guess down.
You go first.
I said 61. What did you say?
I said 68.
Okay.
And I thought I went too young.
I don't know.
Whoa.
How old is Pierce Brosnan, Gavin?
He is only 69.
Oh,
hey,
wow. You're only
one off.
That's good. You're 1 year off, but that's not nearly enough because I had such a big... Celebrate me for a minute. Be kind.
No, because the thing is if I am kind, you'll just say, yeah, I know. I'm the best. I'm the greatest.
I don't think that's true at all. Just please try.
Well done.
Thank you very much. Because I'm the greatest. All right. So I won that one. A shocker. So now you need to add Pierce Brosnan. And he was how old again, Gavin? 69?
69, yes.
69 to the actual ages of the first two people we put up. I'll give you one of them was Emilio Estevez. But you had to be listening. So if you can add those all together, you can win a prize right now. 855-33-WAY-FM is the number. That's 855-33-WAY-FM.
Why are we wasting our time with these old people anyway?
Did you just call me old?
Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. Eugenia, welcome to Famous Ages. Now, did you listen to both sections?
Yes, I listened to both.
Okay, that's good because you need to have all the information to actually get this right. So we try to stump each other with the ages of celebrities and well-known personalities, and you have to add all their ages together when we reveal them. It was Emilio Estevez.
Uh-huh, he was 60.
He was 60.
Pierce Brosnan.
He was 69.
Okay, and Carol Burnett.
She was 89.
Okay, so when you add all those three together, because you did listen, what's your total? Now you have to do math.
218.
218 is absolutely right! Nicely done, Eugenia. You are a winner today, and you're picking up a Way FM prize pack. And we like to have a little fun, too, just based on a very small amount of information, try to guess your age as well. Here, I have got a good question for you. Did you watch Carol Burnett, the Carol Burnett Show, when it was on live?
Yes.
You did. Okay. So, Eugenia's got to be, depending on how old she was when she was watching it live, she's at least my age.
Yeah, I'm going to say she's 61.
That was a good guess. I went 64. I always hate guessing higher on women. I should have guessed 44, but I did not. Because of her name, too, Eugenia. That's a unique older name. So, what do you think, Eugenia? How close are we?
I'm 59.
59!
Ooh, I was closer.
Betty was
Two
closer.
Years.
And just 5 years older than me. Well, congratulations, Eugenia. We really appreciate you listening to The Wally Show and playing a little Famous Ages with us today.
Awesome. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Oh, electronic mail.
Uplifting Way FM. This is The Wally Show. If you ever want to email me, it's very simple, wally@wayfm.com. I got this cool email. It says, hey, I drive a school bus, and my bus is capable of listening to music through Bluetooth, and I have my phone, and I stream it on my bus. I have 50-plus channels ranging from 50s to 90s with rock, metal, rap, etc. But yesterday, I was delivering my elementary route when Ann Wilson, My Jesus, came on, and a little girl behind me asked me to turn it up, and she started singing along with the song. That's cool, because, I mean, this person is kind of using the bus route and music as an outreach, too, you know?
And that's what's awesome about listening to Way FM is that it can be an outreach anywhere you are.
Yes, as it just made my day, and I wanted to share the blessing that I received. Later, later when I was taking high school kids home, a Judas Priest song, because they had it on a different channel, played, and then Phil Wickham, and then the Gospel Gangsters, and I overheard two high schoolers say to each other, "Are we going to hell?" she said, "Was it wrong that I laughed out loud?" But again, kids are listening. We don't think that they are, but they are constantly listening. And what are they going to be influenced by? You know, and so we have the opportunity and the ability to put things in front of them that are really good for them, you know, all the time. So there you go. If you ever want to hit me up, so simple, wally@wayfm.com.
Well, that's the end, but it doesn't have to be. Check out our Aftercast. It's new stuff you didn't hear in the podcast. Be sure to rate us on iTunes, as well as connect with us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok. Just search Wally Show. And be sure to join our exclusive Potty Facebook group. You can find the link in the description of this podcast. And thanks to Colorado Christian University Online and United Faith Mortgage for supporting what we do.